Hi, today I'm going to be showing you how to use microRDK's over-the-air updates feature. And before I do that, I want to talk a little bit about what is microRDK, what is a microcontroller, and kind of why is this all important. A microcontroller is a little computer like this. It has a smaller form factor than a regular computer, and it's much cheaper. Like these are anywhere from $2 to $20. Unlike a regular computer, they have a real-time operating system. So a few differences are that the software is much more closely tied to the hardware, or it could be bare metal in some cases, so there's no operating system. Because of that, you have to what we call flash the device with all of the code that it can run. So it can flash code in C, C++, Rust, things like that. And the flashing process can take place either over a wire that's connected to your com another computer that has the binary that you want to flash, or you can do it over Wi-Fi. So up until now, Viam has supported the over-the-wire flashing, and we just recently added support for over-the-air or over Wi-Fi. So I'm going to walk you through both and show you how much easier and more convenient it is to do it over the air. Okay, so here we are on app.vm.com, and I have a machine that has not been set up yet, and we're going to go through the process to flash this ESP32 with microRDK using the over-the-wire method. You do have to use the over-the-wire method the first time you flash just to get microRDK onto the device, but once you do that, we can use over-the-air updates for all of your updates after that. So let's start with that. We'll go to the setup instructions. We want to run on an ESP32, and I'm using my MacBook to be the device that I'm installing the binary from. So let's follow the download and install instructions. We'll start by installing this command line utility called the Viam Micro Server Installer, and we'll also download the credentials for this machine on app.vm.com. That way, when it starts up, it knows to connect to app with these credentials. And finally, we'll copy these instructions. So going over to my downloads folder, I'm going to be making the installer command line utility actually runnable. And then I'm going to be invoking it with the write flash command. And I'm passing it that cloud credentials that we just downloaded. Monitor means show the logs. And then I'm going to add my Wi-Fi name. You do have to use a Wi-Fi network that supports 2G, so just make sure you do that. And this can happen on some operating systems that require you to enable running software downloaded from the internet. So let's fix that real quick. Cancel, and then let's go over to our system settings to make that runnable. We'll go down to privacy and security, and then you should have a little alert here for something that you tried to run that was blocked. So we'll say allow anyway. All right. Now let's try that again. And I'm going to say open. Okay, cool. So we're going to flash the latest production release of microRDK version 040. Yes, downloading. And the Wi-Fi password. This is going to get stored on the device. Here it's asking you to select which USB port your device is connected to. And if you want to figure out how to do that, we can link you to the docs. Okay. And then we just wait for those bytes to get flashed over the wire onto the device. Okay, and we're now done with flashing the firmware has rebooted to apply what we just flashed onto it. And you can see that microRDK has started up. We see all of those logs. And we'll come back to these logs in a second when we do our over-the-air update. But let's jump back to app.vm.com. We see that we have detected that the device is up and running. We can go ahead to the config tab. So here is where you could start to add modules for any hardware that you want to connect to your device, usually through the GPIO pins. But we're just going to flash another copy of the firmware using over-the-air update. So we're going to add the OTA service. It's not yet in the dropdown in app.vm.com, so we're going to go over to the docs and copy it from the over-the-air updates section under build and integrate. We'll copy the JSON here. I'll grab the entire services array since we don't have anything else configured. Go over to the raw JSON editor and then paste that in. There are two attributes that you have to update. One is the URL that you're hosting the firmware at. So one key thing is that if you're using this method, you do have to make your firmware accessible at some publicly accessible URL. And then we'll change this version name string to just anything. You can call it version one, version two, chicken, something to let MicroRDK know that there has been a change to this configuration. Go ahead and download the firmware from this URL again. So I have the latest RC release of MicroRDK here on a Google Cloud bucket, and I'm going to copy the URL. This is version 4.1 RC9. So if you remember, we flashed version 040 before over the wire. Okay, so I got that URL. And I'm going to just call this version 1. Before I save, I want to show you some things in the logs that'll help make it really clear what's happening behind the scenes. So when MicroRDK started up, it printed its partition table. This is the non-volatile storage on the device. And it has a few different slots, and you can see their addresses up here. So this is the partition table. Importantly, it has a few slots for doing OTA, OTA 0, OTA 1. And whenever it boots, it's going to boot the firmware from one of these slots, whichever one was last written to. So it will also tell you that it loaded, in this case, from offset 0x200000, and that is OTA 0. When we do this OTA, it's going to detect that change to the Viam config and then reboot to pick up the new OTA service in the URL. Then it'll say, oh, okay, there's a URL here. I'm going to reboot again. Well, I'm going to download that firmware into OTA 1, then reboot again from OTA 1. And we'll be able to see that it has loaded from this other address. So let's go ahead and do that. We'll hit save. And it takes a few seconds for MicroRDK to detect that config change. We can see it's detected it and it's going ahead to download into that other partition 0x3A0000. And we'll just wait for this to complete. Okay, here we see the reboot. And once we boot back up, we'll see that we loaded from that OTA 1 partition this time. So that's great. Now we're running version 041 RC9 of MicroRDK. Even though I did leave the ESP32 connected to my laptop, you could have just left your ESP32 wherever you had it installed. It might be plugged in somewhere else. It might be running on a battery somewhere else. But the really nice thing about OTA updates is that you don't have to unplug it from wherever it is, come bring it to your laptop. You can just update that URL in the config and deploy a new version. This is also really useful if you have a whole fleet of ESP32s and you don't want to come and get each one. You can just deploy new firmware to all of them over the air.